What's up, guys? Plum Ninja here, and welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin. So we are over here in the next area of Dranglake Castle, and we have our old buddy Benhart over here. Oh, and a summon sign, and it's a sun bro. Oh God, I see that build way too many times.
Journeyed from the distant east to perfect my swordsmanship. And legend has it that powerful beings slumber in this land. My sword has been in my family for generations, and only a real man can wield it true. I may face any man or beast, but none shall be a match for my sword. This land is the right mess, eh?
Yeah.
King's gone. The people have a mad glint in their eyes. The land itself is overrun by terrible beasts. No better place to test my sword, eh?
Eh? I guess we're Canadian.
This land is the right... The land itself...
Okay, shut up. Shut up, Benhart. You're a real bro, but shut up. Okay. So this next area is pretty short. The only thing is, we just need to bring down this elevator and then make our way around, back around over to the bonfire area, and then ride the elevator. Or we could just warp back, but I don't want to be lazy. I don't think any of these activate. No, they don't. Where are you? There you are. Ah! There we are. Okay. Let's bring these guys over here. Come here. Ooh. Mannequin boots. Turn that shit, bro. All right. Now the elevator is on its way down. Now I could just warp back to, the bonfire. As a matter of fact, that's something I kind of did for most of my playthroughs here. Ooh, we got Soul Greatsword. But that wouldn't be fun. Old King's Hammer. Wait, hold on. What does that look like? Well, Old Knight's Hammer, not Old King's Hammer. God, I can't read. Yeah, Plum, you illiterate fuck. Alright, so we got the executioner's horse over here. This actually used to be, something else. So this guy was never here before. Ow. That hurt. Gower's Ring of Protection. Pretty awesome little ring. Oh God. Human effigy, awesome. Alright, I didn't expect to get ambushed by that other knight. Firestorm, awesome. So if I remember correctly, the other one is a... Yep, it is. It is a traitor! How dare you! This thing is nightmares. So I've seen some concept art from for the Dark Souls 3. They were planning on having different kinds of mimics, or at least these were just concept art. I don't know what they plan on doing with those material. Basically, they're having different type. They were planning on having different types of mimics. One was like a bonfire mimic. One was a ladder mimic, and I think I even seen like an item mimic or something like that. So that would have been really cool to see. In my opinion, I think that would have added something new, something to really scare me. Because the first time I encountered a mimic was pretty terrifying. And we got a gargoyle over here. I am going to be taking this guy on. If I can lock onto him. Oh, god damn it. Oh, god. Hang on. Retreat. Where'd he go? Oh, I think he flew off. Uh-oh. That can't be bueno. That's not racist. Oh god! Oh man, she blew my face! I better have gotten an item from that shit. Well, I got an item, but it wasn't what I wanted. Estus Flash Shard, sweet. Let's pull the lever. Pull the lever! Wrong lever! Now I want to go watch Emperor's New Groove. That crap was funny. My parents thought that it was like a really stupid movie. I don't understand why. I thought it was funny. It got a sequel, but it was more, it was called Krunk's New Groove, and they even had a show, and I believe they were even using the original, voice cast. Except for Pacha. I don't think they were using John Goodman for Pacha. I don't know why I do this little sword dance. You do it with a great sword, it's even funnier. Oh, speaking of great swords, if I can get it, and if also I can wield it, there is a particular great sword that I do plan on using, even though I am not going to be a strength build. Oh yeah, I forgot about this guy. We have to go get a particular item to stick it in his bosom, and by bosom they mean face. And you guys will see what I'm talking about. Keys of the King's Passage. So basically just on to the next area. Soul Vessel, that's actually an item I talked about earlier. You take it over to the old fire keepers, which are those ladies in red that we saw at the beginning of the game, and you give it to them and it allows you to reallocate your stats. So even though I chose a swordsman to do a dex build, I didn't have to build it that way. I could have easily made it a strength build, but that's not what I wanted to go for. Okay, next area. King's Passage. Yeah, just a strange item just sitting here, an alluring skull. When I first saw this tree, I thought they were trying to make a reference to Dark Souls 1 with the Bed of Chaos. As a matter of fact, we will see a reference to the Bed of Chaos later in the game. Oh boy. Come on, I want your stuff. I want your twin blade. These twin blades are actually pretty good. I've only gotten one, and I've had a lot of victories with it in invasions and dueling. Not saying that it's a guaranteed win. But it's a lot of fun to use. As a matter of fact, I'm debating on whether or not I should go get a twin blade because they are pretty fun to use. Is this Ben Hart? No, it's Ashen Knight Boyd. Here's Ben Hart. Okay, so we have to summon Ben Hart in order to complete his quest line in, I don't remember if he has to survive, but it probably would be a good idea to make sure he does. Onwards. Ow, dick. Get him, Ben Hart. Whoa! Ow! Ow! Smash my face in. Ow! Oh boy. Oh, this boss is actually a really unique boss. I didn't even bother mentioning this. But I guess because I just don't like talking. Oh, come on. What the hell? That was weird. Oh boy. Oh god. Okay. So, sorry, I'm just trying to... I'm trying to concentrate, but at the same time, I want to make sure I... Oh, God. So, this boss is very unique, and how it works is a little similar to... the old monk... Okay, now I can talk. Now, how this boss fight works is a little similar to the old monk of Demon Souls. Now I've never had the chance to do it myself on this game, but I have had it happen to me. Basically, if you put your red soapstone down somewhere in the castle, they say if you do it in the King's Passage, it's a much better chance, but it's like a one in a thousand chance.
it's better if you do it into King's Passage, but I've heard that you can even do it over in Dranglake Castle. So you can get summoned by this boss and actually asked to... you can actually get summoned in here when he drops his shield like that and summons a character, summons a NPC to fight you. You can be summoned into this world and defeat the host, so it counts as an invasion. You don't get anything out of it that I know of. However, you do get to participate in a boss fight as an invader, which is really cool. Something I kind of wish that From Software kind of kept as a mechanic, because the first time that they've had something like this was in Demon Souls with the Old Monk. The Old Monk was one of the archdemons. I was going to say the great demons. They're one of the archdemons that you need to defeat. They had an NPC version, but they also had, as long as there were characters around, and also you you dropped your sign down or your stone down, you could get summoned by the Old Monk and be the boss fight, which was really cool. That's kind of died down. I've got a chance to do that once, and I've also had the chance to fight someone in that boss fight once. I lost, obviously. But in this one, they kind of bring it back. They said you become an assistant, kind of like an assistant to the to that boss, rather than being the actual boss itself. And I've only had it happen to me one time, but I've never been able to do it myself. And it wasn't because, like, oh, I came in late into the game. Actually, I tried doing that all the way from, like, when I first started playing this game, which is around, just shortly after this game came out. And you can see all kinds of videos of it up. Ah, beautiful music. All right. So, I hate to cut this video short, but I gotta make a phone call. So, so I will see you guys in the next episode. So we made it over down here to the Shrine of Armana. And we're going to find out a little bit of lore to this area, as well as we are going to do some exploration, at least the best I can, while still making some progress here. We will be getting through, hopefully, both areas and be able to complete the exploration around here. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. See ya!